away from Thad Matta, and you're starting to see some of the effects of the recruiting with the DJ Cooper and some of the other young guys they brought in.
Yeah, he's being able to get a guy like Reggie Kiwi out of Cleveland Heights, you know, here to stay in the state of Ohio. That's important as well, but Geno Ford's got a ton of talent on his team. They are 9-0 in this tournament as the number one seed.
Yeah, and that's an interesting point, Jordan. Kent State has never lost in the MAC tournament when they're the number one overall seed in the draw. So curious to see how that plays out, because I think this year, you know, as I just discussed with Mutch, I really believe this is anybody's tournament. If one team gets hot, you know, shooting from the field or whatever, you know, as Tony always says, you know, and I agree, when it comes to March, one half of hot shooting or one half of cold shooting, and either you're moving on or you're done.
Time for the tip.
We are underway at Quicken Loans Arena. Set the starting lineups for you. Ohio wins the opening tap. DJ Cooper, Tommy Freeman in the backcourt with Bassett, Keeley, and Van Kempen up front. It's Bassett on the near side, kicking it to Van Kempen at the top of the key. Ball knocked away. Steal by Rodriguez Sherman. Comes down on the break. Little layup is up off the glass. No, tapped up and in. Whistle, no basket. Basket interference on Chris Singletary. They'll wave it off. No score, 20 seconds in.
Well, that's exactly what we're going to see out of Kent State. They are a very athletic team. They're a very quick team, and they like to get out in transition. That time, though, we went from not. Ohio, luckily, with the empty possession there.
Starters for Kent State, Rodriguez Sherman and Chris Singletary in the backcourt with Kyrie Evans, Frank Henry, Allah, and Justin Green up front. Bassett on the far side, kicks it to Van Kempen at the top of the key, hands off to DJ Cooper, the MAC Freshman of the Year for 2009-2010. In the far post, they go backing his man down to the front, hit no good for Kelly, and the rebound pulled in by Kent State. Back come the Golden Flashes right in front of us. Singletary jumping for three is no good. Rebound though pulled in by Kyrie Evans. Back to Sherman at the top of the key, off to Evans on the far side. Far post, it goes to Green. Little hook shot is up, no good. Rebound tapped out of bounds off Kent State. It'll be Ohio basketball.
That's really not the game for Kent State. Dump the ball inside of Justin Green. Let's see some touches for the Golden Flashes. That's a more effective offense. Meanwhile, for Ohio in that other possession there, they try to get the ball in the right Reggie Kiwi, and I think he's uber important tonight. He has been a non-factor in the two losses thus far for Ohio against Kent State.
We're a minute in. Third game of our quarterfinal quadruple header. Cooper at the top of the key, off to Van Kempen, jumping for two from the top of the key is no good. And the rebound pulled in by Green for Kent State.
One and done for Ohio, one and done.
Now Green is such a good rebound. And Sherman will bring it back to the Golden Flashes with the left-handed dribble to Singletary on the near side, gets double team backs out of it. Nice feed inside, layup good for Rodriguez Sherman, first two for Kent State.
And that was all executed by Chris Singletary. I mean, he is a walking stat machine that time with the assist.
2-0 Golden Flashes. Cooper back for OU, drives in the lane, but a floater is up. No good, whistle, charging foul, going to be called on DJ Cooper.
Yeah, great job there again by Singletary. He could do it on the offensive end, Aaron. He could do it on the defensive end. Take the charge there for DJ Cooper. Great in transition with the basketball, but that time he was out of control. Got called for the charge.
18:23 to go first half. Just underway from Quicken Loans Arena in downtown Cleveland. 2-0 Kent State. Singletary's got it on the near side. The Green at the top of the key. Flips it on the far side. It goes to Evans. Evans to Green at the foul line. Head fakes, drives. Kicks it back out Sherman. Open three-pointer from the near side off the back rim, though. Rebound is loose and pulled in by Van Kempen. And back comes OU on the break. Basket, pull up three. Back rim, no. Rebound pulled in by Rodriguez Sherman for Kent State. Back come the Golden Flashes right to left. Sherman dribbling with the right hand to Singletary. Back to Sherman at the top of the key holding it. Way out near half court. High post to Jason Green. Nice feed inside, knocked away, out of bounds off Ohio, and it'll be Kent State ball with 20 on the shot clock.
Yeah, it's a little two-man game being worked there for the Golden Flashers inside with Justin Green. It was off the hands of Ohio, out of bounds inside for Kent State.
Sherman to inbound underneath his own basket. Flips it out to Evans at the top of the key. He'll hand it back to Rodriguez Sherman, the junior point guard for the Kent State Golden Flashers, guarded by Cooper. Comes off the Justin Green screen, gets double team, comes off another screen, gets in the lane, kicks it off, far corner jumper is good, no good for Evans, Cooper to rebound for Ohio, they want to run. Cooper, ahead of the field, it goes wide open, looks for three, is up and good for Tommy Freeman, the best three-point shooter in the country.
And that's exactly what we expect out of Ohio U. They knock down threes in bunches. This time it's Freeman, probably call his name a couple more times today, Aaron.
Yeah, Tommy Freeman shooting 48% from three-point lane, sixth best in the country.
I think that's better than Shaq from the free throw line.
I think it is. Evans at the top of the key. Ball knocked away from him. Loose ball picked back up. Hands it back to Kyrie Evans. In the post, it goes to Singletary. Gets in the lane. Little leaning up on Chris Templeton, and he gets fouled. And Chris Singletary will go to the line to shoot two free throws.
And that's just a veteran move by Chris Singletary. He's undersized at the forward position, but he takes it up against Van Tepen, picks up the foul, and deserves to go to the charity stripe.
Second team foul on Ohio. Singletary to the line. This year, a 63% free throw shooter. The first one is in and out. No good.
Chris Singletary is going to end up going down in one of the best players in Kent State history. And again, he's a stat machine, over 1,000 points. He can rebound, he can float, he assists the basketball, steals, all defensive first team for the MAC. He's a quality player for the Golden Flash.
That's on sale, steps into the game. Cooper takes a two-second free throw, no good. Still 3-2 Ohio with the lead. Cooper back to three, an open three-pointer, and this time no good. The rebound is loose and out of bounds. It is off Kent State with the Ohio basketball.
And I'll tell you what, John Gross right now on the Ohio sideline can't be happy with these quick possessions, quick shots in the half court for the Bobcats thus far.
Sales inbounds to Bassett. Bassett with the right hand to dribble off the Van Kempen screen. Bassett to the near side. Dribbling now between his legs. He's picked up there by Henry Awa. Nice feed in the lane is picked up by Van Kempen. Jumper is up and good for Kenneth Van Kempen.
Yeah, look what I found. Open 16-foot jump shot from the shoulder, and he knocked it down. Nice job there by the senior.
5-2 Bobcats with the lead. Kent State's got to get this back under control. 16-20 to go here in the half.
Excuse me, Van Kempen Jr. He's still got one more.
Henry Awa to Green at the top and two off to Singletary on the near side. Nice block by Van Kempen. Loose ball picked up. Layup good. Count the basket and a foul. Chris Singletary, ball fired up. He's going to go to the line with a chance to tie.
On the second effort there, and that's going to be critical for John Gross because that's going to put the junior Van Kempen in foul trouble, I believe, picking up his second foul of the first half.
Devon Washington will check in for Ohio. Reggie Keeley, the Cleveland Heights grad, will take a seat. And Anthony Simpson, the sixth man of the year in the conference, will check in for Kent State.
Yeah, I mean, he averages just close to 9 points and 6 rebounds a game off the bench for the Bobcats. Really critical because it's a small rotation for Ohio.
Singletary's free throw no good. He's missed three in a row. He's still 5-4 Ohio with the lead. 16 minutes to go here in the first half. Bassett at the top of the key off to Freeman on the far side. Gets in the far post to Van Kempen. Turn on hook side. He's up off the rim. No rebound. And picked up by Van Kempen. Got his own board. Bassett open three from the top of the key.
I'll tell you, hard on Bassett. He's a big-time quality player. Champion from IU. Knocks down the big shot from the top of the key on the offensive rebound and tip back by the Bobcats.
Bobcats 8, Golden Flash 4, 15:40 to go here in the half. Singletary at the top of the key. That three-point shooting for Ohio, very important to their success. Sherman's got it on the north side, right in front of us. Hands off to Singletary, guarded by Washington. Singletary drives baseline, goes under the basket, layup is up, blocked and good. Pitches on the rebound, layup good for Chris Singletary, very consistent.
Singletary, pure power on the inside and effort by Singletary to get his own offensive miss and put it up for two.
Singletary's got 4, the Golden Flash is 6. It's 8-6 Ohio with the lead. The Swan Sales got it on the near side, ball knocked away, scored by Singletary. Singletary, all man, on the break, layup good.
Great job, Josie Weiss, first team All-MAC defensively with the steal, an uncontested layup for the team.
Quick 6 points for Chris Singletary, we're tied at 8. Bassett at the top of the key, dribbles it out of traffic, gets it to Sales on the near side, trying to get in the post to Washington, he does, immediately double team, ball knocked away, stolen by Green. Ahead to Rodriguez Sherman, which seems like Kent State's the best defensive team in this time. Farside three-pointer is up and no good for Evans. Loose ball goes back by Sales and Ohio comes out of the pack. Here. Tied at 8, 14:30 to go here in the half. Bassett, top of the key picked up by Simpson. Backs him down, whistles, another violation going to be called, and I'm on Bassett. And there's a timeout on the floor. 14:28 to go in the first half. Kent State and Ohio tied at 8. You're listening to the Mid-American Conference Tournament on ESPN 850 WKNR and ESPNCleveland.com.
H1N1 flu virus has hit young people hard. It's not too late to get an H1N1 flu vaccine to protect yourself and those around you. The flu ends with you. Get vaccinated. Text FLU to 2527.
Back at Quicken Loans Arena in downtown Cleveland, Aaron Goldhammer, Jordan Sherwood, game three of our quadruple header of action earlier today. Western Michigan and Akron won their games. They advanced to the semifinals. They'll play each other 7 o'clock tomorrow here at the Q. And right now, 14-28 to go first half. Kent and Ohio tied at 8. Jordan, let's take a look at some of the stats.
Yeah, what's jumping out to me right off the bat is Ohio's 2 out of 4 from 3. We'd expect that out of the Bobcats. They're one of the best three-point shooting teams, not only obviously in the conference, but I think in the country. But critical for them, DJ Cooper has 2 fouls that has forced Armand Bassett to be handling the basketball for the Bobcats. On the other end, when you look at Kent State, I think it's all Chris Singletary, and why not? He's a first-team All-MAC player, first-team All-MAC defense, got a couple of steals, 6 points thus far, but the free-throw shooting, Aaron, the free-throw shooting right now for the Golden Flash. I know it's early. I mean, it's 14-28 to go in the first half, but you got to make free throws. It's March.
Yeah, Singletary 0 of 3 from the line. He's 3 of 6 from the floor. He's already thrown up 6 shots in the first 5:32 of the game. It's Kent State basketball.
And it looks like number 22, Mike McKee, the 6'5 senior, will make his first appearance for the Golden Flashes.
Yeah, this is a senior-laden or an experienced Golden Flashes team, and that should bode well for them in this tournament. Inbound pass to Green, ball knocked away from him out of bounds.
And again, too, I think you got to throw in, they're very confident and comfortable here at the Q. I mean, a lot of fans come up from Kent to follow the Golden Flashes, and again, they're 9-0 as a team as the number one seed in this tournament.
Kent State will check Randall Holt into the ballgame as well. Rodriguez Sherman will sit down. Inbound pass grabbed by Simpson. Back to Holt. Trapped in the backcourt, got to get it across. Back to McKee, to Holt, comes across to Henry Alla, and they get it across just in time.
Yeah, just in time, too. Now they put the basketball in the hands of the freshman from Bedford, Ohio, Randall Holt.
Holt will dribble it between his legs, picked up by Bassett, brings it to the near side to McKee. McKee tries to drive on Freeman, brings it back out, goes in the near post to Justin Green, faces up Van Kempen, gets in the lane, with it, traveling violation on Green.
Yeah, that's a tough matchup there. A little bit out of position, Justin Green, as he rotated to the paint, tried to lay it up with the right hand, but took one too many steps, called for the traveling.
Yeah, I'm surprised. I thought Justin Green could have won player in the year in the conference, Jordan, and he was on the All-MAC second team.
Yeah, second
maybe
team
a little
All-MAC,
bit of a snub. Yeah.
6'8 sophomore, I mean, he's definitely a threat down low, but it's got to be a factor for the Golden Flashes if they want to win.
Van Kempen's got on the near side, his jumper's up off the front rim. No, Holt leaping high in the air to grab that rebound. The kid's got some eyes.
Should have touched the shot clock.
Holt to Henry Alla, drives baseline, kicks it far corner. Open three from the key is off the side of the backboard. No, ugly shot. Rebound pulled in by Bassett. Back comes Ohio. Sales got it on the near side, pulls it back down to Bassett at the top of the key. 13-20 to go. First half, still tied at 8. Bassett comes off the screen, foul line, kicks to Freeman, 5-point three's good. Tommy Freeman getting hot from beyond the arc.
Yeah, 2 out of 3 right now for Tommy Freeman. Did a great job, but that was all developed by Armand Bassett getting inside the seams and finding the open man. Now
Freeman, one of the best three-point shooters, not only in the MAC, but in the entire country, percentage-wise. McKee with it at the top of the key, flips it on the far side to Simpson. Follow-away jumper is off the back rim, though. Offensive rebound, though, pulled in by Green. Green puts it on the floor, back in the lane. Shot is up and good for Justin Green.
What a patient move by Justin Green. He gathered the offensive rebound, realized no one was around him, and just took it to the hoop and scored it with the right hand.
Bassett, who's been running the point since Cooper went to the bench early in this first half, dribbling with the left hand, gets it to the top of the key, off to Van Kempen on the near side. Near post, it goes to Washington. Back to the far side, Bassett. Open three from the top of the key. Is good.
And that's the second three. Armand Bassett is knocked down when he's been wide open. Great ball movement by the Bobcats.
14-10, Ohio with the lead. 12-20 to go, first half. Holt will bring it across for Kent State. Off to Simpson on the near side. Bobcat fans getting excited. McKee, foul line jumper off the back rim. No. Offensive rebound, no for Simpson. Ball knocked away from him. Loose on the ground. And I thought they were going to call a hold ball. They don't. Kent State comes out of the pack with it. Whistle, traveling violation. Holt was on the ground and shuffled his feet. And they called him for the travel.
That was just crazy. There were 8 bodies on the floor going for that pass.